It is time that we say labbaik to the call to walk away from stress, anxiety, depression, tension. That should not be part of a Muslim's vocabulary. To walk away from the feelings of despair, hopelessness, to walk away of lack of interest in life. Just walk amongst nature, be amongst the greens. Because through walking, it releases the body's own natural antidepressants, endorphins. And what is endorphins? It is known amongst the doctors as the happy drug.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Muhammad Zain, our colleague, our great friend on the VOC, on Q&A questions of Islamic matters. We welcome you here, mashallah. And as you know, Muhammad Zain is also a fitness fundi. He's regular at the gym, and we just want some input from him as encouragement for us and for the people of why you are in the gym, what's the need of the exercise, what is the benefits thereof, inshallah.
Alhamdulillah, assalamu alaikum to you, Moulana Dawood. First and foremost, let me say, looking at...
What keeps Sheikh so slim and trim, alhamdulillah?
Yeah, there are many things that keeps me slim and trim. Allow me to start with the spiritual side. I, for all the years...
Allah Ta'ala remind for us that van water bring Allah Ta'ala leave life to everything that once was dead. Allahu Akbar.
Every step amongst nature, respected friends, should bring one closer to Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala.
An example that I for us here on Jumu'ah. A well-to-do takalani by a nice man, ma'Allah bi jannahi. Lekker vrouw, kook lekker potte kos. Kennis, lekker kennis, lekker te saam. Everyone treated the same. They go on holidays, go tini. They go for umrah. Every Friday they sit together as a family, have family meals together. The father taught them love and respect for one another and be together there the day when I'm no longer there. The day the father left this world, there's one thing he did not sign up for, and that was the will. He delayed, he knew about it, he had knowledge about it, like you today had the knowledge today, but you took it for granted. So he died. That same family that was eating together now, no more eats together. The mother that is behind, some of them don't even want to visit the mother because of anger, of greed, of money. Maar geliefde broers, alhoewel, lang story kort, dis die condition. Maar nou vraag ek en u vir ons die question. Kan ons blame daar die kinders dat hulle nie meer mekaar wil groet nie, hulle wil nie meer by een tafel sit nie, hulle harte is kwaad. Diezelfde pa wat hulle gehak het voor liefgewees en saam geëet het, graag omraad en saam, holidays en saam, die familie so gehou, vandag is die familie van nie meer te saam nie, because of money. Then we say, no, it's the sons, it's this son, and it's thy son. Nee, it's not the sons, it's not the daughters, it is you, the father. You people sitting here, it's you. And you don't blame your children. Because, my geliefde broers, you gooi a stuk vlees in the animal kingdom. They forget who they are. It's a road map to help us along the journey towards effective parenting. It is the result of several years of workshops and lectures conducted on family-related issues. So, mashallah, mag Allah ta'ala hoekloon hierdie broer, wie Allah ta'ala geïnspireerd, om van A tot Z, soos altyd geleer het, toe ons in school was of in Christ was, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, en sê A stem for apple, B for banana, en C for cake or custard, whatever. Maar, hier gaat ons leer, a deeper kind of a way, wat hier die Muslim broer vir ons wil sê, wat effectief was, in die plek waar hy da'wa doen, waar hy vir jare observant is met youth, etc. In Canada sy self, kom hy op die eerste een wat sê vir ons, A is for accountability. A is for accountability. You see, a common mistake parents make is to teach their kids to be accountable to them, rather than to be accountable to Allah first and foremost.